Instead of trying to blend the oils to make it look like real life, Suzanne would try to model to create form and depth. Using this technique allowed him to layer color and light, capturing a translucent feeling and vibrating a sense of actually looking at a landscape. Suzanne used color and pattern to bring a sense of structure to his view of the world. Also allowing the brush strokes and gradation of color, Suzanne built configuration. Rather than using lines in his paintings, Suzanne would pepper the colors on a canvas to create form. Using small brush strokes and heavy concentrations of paint, Suzanne would literally lift the structures off the canvas.
One of the most important things Suzanne did that led to Cubism is painting from different viewpoints and also different times. Doing this helps Suzanne imply two different time periods into one painting. This is called simultaneity time. This fascinated many people because since the Renaissance, paintings have always been painted from one straight forward viewpoint.
Winter brought in talented staff, but used them in various ways. One way this is so is by covering politics aggressively and thoroughly. It will devote many pages to political articles. Its typical feature story about politics is far longer than what was found in most newspapers and even in most magazines at the time. Its writers have been unafraid to push extra hard to get the story behind the story. It is not known for simply accepting and publishing the official version of events. Rolling Stone helped define a new style of political commentary, hiring original and irreverent.
Attempting to sue at once the popular and critical voice, Edgar Allan Poe experimented with the death of a beautiful woman, told from the lips of a bereaved lover, which he believed was unquestionably the most poetic topic in the world. This masterful poem is an example of Gothic poetry, a genre of literature created by Edgar Allan Poe, who would go on to become a great leader of American literature.
The pigs were living in deplorable conditions and they were waiting to go to slaughter so they can look forward to enjoying their long and natural lives.
By creating People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, or PETA, Alex Pacheco and Ingrid Newkirk started a movement to protest and document animals' rights. The legacy of their work was better treatment of and more rights for all animals. When Ingrid Newkirk was 22, she found some kittens that had been abandoned by her neighbor to the local shelter. She thought they would find wonderful homes for the kittens, but when she went back in the back to have a look at the other animals, I found out that they had been put down. Ingrid was shocked at the sight. She'd taken them to a shelter, and they had been killed. Ingrid then thought that she
It began in the end. Cannons fired, gunpowder ignited, people screamed, and bodies littered the ground. Yorktown wasn't the last battle for many of the Americans, including Corporal Robert Shurtleff. Through the pain of injuries, he fought alongside his fellow soldiers, receiving two serious injuries, a gash in his forehead and a musket ball in his upper thigh. He had a doctor clean the gash, but concealed the wound from the musket ball and removed it himself. However, by what accounts exist, Robert Shurtleff was an admirable fighter. He was also concealing an immense secret. Robert Shurtleff was actually Deborah Sampson, a woman in her 20s who dressed as a man to fight in the war. While Deborah Sampson was not the first woman to dress as a man in order to fight in war, other stories include Hannah Snell, Sally St. Clair, and Molly Pitcher. Deborah's story captured the minds and hearts of Americans. By fighting in the Revolutionary War, then explaining and justifying what she did in the public sphere, Deborah Sampson Gannett showed leadership in gender equality, and her legacy aided the fight for feminism in later years.
Having to be a symbol. That he was a symbol, but he didn't have to be only a symbol.
The writers of Captain America comics showed him to be the epitome of American propaganda. However, by leading his comic book industry in many anti-government stories, Captain America became the first real anti-hero. In Captain America's own words, doesn't matter what the press says, doesn't matter what the politics or the mob says, doesn't matter if the whole country decides that something wrong is something right. This nation was founded on one principle above all else, the requirement that we stand up for what we believe in, no matter the odds or the consequences. When the mob and the press and the whole world tell you to move, your job is to plant yourself like a tree beside the river of truth and tell the whole world, no, you move.
While her leadership changed the country, her death left a void in the horse protection movement. As soon as Velma Johnson passed away in 1977, a different bill was created in Congress that allowed helicopters to gather wild horses again. While it's still illegal to sell them for slaughter, over the next 40 years, ranchers and business interests have chipped away at the protections, and once again, wild mustangs and burros find themselves in danger from ranchers and hunters. However, in her lifetime, Velma Johnson was very successful and led people to push Congress for protections for horses, showing that the fight to save the wild mustangs could be won. When once asked how she felt about her successes, Velma Johnson replied, "Have you ever wondered how it feels to touch a star? I can pretty well tell you about it now."